Structure and reactivity are inseparably related. Recall that we think about chemical reactions on an energy diagram as proceeding from an energy well, the starting materials, over a peak, the transition state, and finally down to another energy well, the products. The structure, and more importantly, the stability of all three of these structures figures into reactivity in a very profound way. More stable transition states, for instance, often lead to faster reactions. More stable products can lead to more exothermic reactions. Because the stability and structure of intermediates and transition states is so relevant to reactivity, in this lesson we're going to take a look at the factors that influence the stability of reactive intermediates, including charged species, which we've already seen, as well as some new species that we haven't dealt with yet. We'll also introduce the concept of bond order, and how we can use it to predict bond length, strength, and reactivity. Bond strength is one of the keys to molecular energy, so comparing the total bond strength of one molecule to another gives us a good idea of their relative stabilities, and more importantly, insight into the direction of equilibrium between the two. As you progress through this lesson, keep in mind that the end game is an understanding of the factors that control the stability of reactive intermediates. Understanding these factors will give you insight into reactivity. For instance, we can see on the diagram I've drawn here that stabilization of the products will lead to a larger energy gap between the starting materials and products and a more exothermic reaction. This helps explain the very large amount of heat, for instance, that's released during a reaction that's very thermodynamically favorable. We can use considerations of reactive intermediates and their stability to explain these experimental observations.